there, peeps. Celine here, and welcome back to Xenosaga Episode 3. The day this video we posted will mark the 10th day. 10 meaning. The day that this will be posted will mean I got 11 days into my birthday. Remember, on the second video posted on the days will be when I do my countdown. Because starting at the 30th of April, the day this video will be posted, will be when I actually start my countdown to my birthday, which is May 10th. Now, Xenosaga will be posted on that day, so you get your normal two videos, but I will also do an extra video the day before my birthday, so you guys get a heads up when my birthday actually is. But I will tell you this, it is the second week of May, and it's on a Wednesday this year. But anyway, so let's get back to Xenosaga.
Boundary strength of the surface is 910
E. Damn, you're kidding! Touch that and say goodbye, huh? Gnosis! Why are they here?
Xion, there's no time. Head straight for the coordinates.
I got it. Are you ready, Cosmos?
Initialization complete. Safety released.
We're in range. Do it anytime, Cosmos.
Acknowledged.
Chief, maybe this is beyond us.
Just believe in Cosmos. It's all right. I know that she'll be able to do it.
Setting weapon deployment to maximum output.
Had penetrated the hypersphere. The surface fissure is closed. Gnosis swarm in the surrounding space has disappeared. All ES craft lost from radar. All communications are cut off.
All right, they've made it through.
It's too early to celebrate.
Now, keep in mind, my character is on the Durando with these two.
The Gnosis probably vanished in order to pursue them. The real challenge starts now.
I'm sure they'll manage. We just have to believe in them.
Now, keep in mind, I haven't actually thought out my OC as far as this game goes.
You sure are infatuated with her. Is it regret from the time when you still wore a mantle of flesh?
Did I ever do my opening? Yeah, I did.
Or is it because of ambition you still hold? So now you're going to use the daughter in place of the imperfect mother? The maiden who invites the spreading gnosis? You're one heartless bastard. And it's not like you don't know what this is going to cause.
It is necessary for the new world. Is your cloak just a decoration?
I don't like the idea of that thing as the womb, but whatever. I'll give you a hand. We just need to destroy Cosmos, right?
It is beyond your power. The only one who can destroy Cosmos is Telos.
Oh, really? So I guess my job is to attend to the princess's little whims. Works for me. I'll lead the entourage.
What does a scan of the interior show?
Temperature, 18 degrees Celsius. Pressure, 0.94. Wind speed at landing point is 20 meters per second.
18 degrees Celsius. I don't even know what that is.
Atmosphere is 77% nitrogen, 20% oxygen with traces of argon and carbon dioxide. The air is breathable.
What's the Elsa's position? Can we get in touch with the crew?
There's a response on the underside of the object.
I'm opening the channel.
Sound like you're doing just fine.
Of course. You can't run a salvage business if you let every little setback get you down.
Looks like there's a couple of exceptions to that rule.
Hey, stop goofing around and get to your posts.
We're on our way there now. Get the hangar ready for us.
Roger. We'll be waiting to welcome you.
Can't escape? Why?
We haven't got a clue. Hey, Hammer!
The logical drive isn't responding at all. There should be nothing wrong with it since it's fully repaired and functioning normally. Anyway, I haven't got a clue.
If the logical drive isn't working, there's nothing we can do.
Yes. As things are now, the environmental bugs will run out of resources first. And then, we'll eventually run out of water and oxygen.
Professor?
Something in this strange land must be affecting it. We'll have to go out and have a look.
You're certain that something in this land is causing it?
It's impossible to be sure, but I think it's worth investigating.
Gotcha! Captain, get things ready so you can launch at any time. Don't worry, we'll have you out of here in no time.
So this is the Elsa 3.0. I don't think I can go find me to go back. No, I have the decoder for that, but don't have the location. Oh, yeah, I do have a reason to go back. just have all of it. Well, in that case, I'll have two of each. I just like having 10 of everything. Everyone puts that on because it guards against poison. Make sure everyone gets that. Now do their suits. That's more important than sensor. All right, now save. Oh, we need to talk to the professor to kick off the much longer side quest for that giant robot. He's not in here. Alright, if you're heading to the thing though, you need to make sure you're ready. I know, I'll give you one of my... Awesome. Here's that game. I'll probably end up playing a lot of it later on. This is the female's room. In fact, later you get to see a cutscene here. This is the man's cave. Survival wear. Let's go downstairs. And head south for the new robotic academy. This is cool. And you can't leave the room while it's activated. Learn the ether skill at the robot. I got the robot. I doubt I have the robot. Professor. Solitary life of the island south. I have finished the kaiju. Seize that of your where fury. Wait, does that mean, she has She has that robot. A small lightning ether attack to all enemies. Oh, we will be spending a lot of time in this area. At least later on. Because this is where Cosmos... Oh yeah, Cosmos gets another outfit. Later. Okay, go down to... I want to go down. Can I not go down? I know I technically have to go to this one. Okay, now let's go back. Wait. Go all the way on the north side. In the north. There's a door. Now let's go back to the main floor. Locate sector number 8. All right, I think I know where it is. I know it's past this. Get out of my way. Yeah, it's past here. There it is. Tears. It grants us a small amount of money at the end. Don't really need it to tell you the truth. We're good on money. Okay, let's see. Now let's go back to the island. The door's open. You would think with her being robotic, she wouldn't be able to walk in water. I guess she's, safe, I guess. Who are you? I'm surprised that you... Wait, what? So I have fortunate news. I'm sorry to say that Dr. Bishop passed away. But his dream was fulfilled. He felt ill and passed away a few days ago. I'm sorry. Pet the monkey. That's a professor. He said if a woman with long hair wearing a pendant comes by, I want you to show it to her. As soon as I show you, I know your friend. Please switch the console to letter D on it. It's been a long, Shion? It's me, the greatest robotic professor, scientist in the universe. The Dark Professor. How long has it been? I'll never forget the day which you destroyed my masterpiece, the Dark Whatever Kaiser. Since then, I lived to get my revenge. I guess that was in part 2, episode 2. I'm not really sure. By the way, we can't win. By doing this, by the way. Yes, in order to meet you, I optimized you the entire time you've been here on this island to find your weakness. I know you've been fighting the great evil all by yourself, but I know you're suffering, unable to forget that man in your past. I even studied how you live. Remember when you incident Curry disappeared from the refrigerator? That was me. Remember when your closet was a mess, but your underwear was still in there, right? That's because I came to my senses halfway through. Are you a pervert? In this matter, I researched everything about you, and based on that data, I created the strongest robot in the universe. The ultimate robot. No one can defeat it. Not even you, Shion. But my first scene, crazy obsession, also whatever my body. I grow sick and now I can't tell you how much time I have left. This video will be my will. I leave it believing you will come here. Shion, accept my final challenge. Fight my greatest masterpiece. Whatever. By the time you see this recording, I have already passed away. Though my body may perish, my soul lives on. Though the Dark Professor may die, whatever is eternal. I trust you accept this challenge from beyond my grave. Farewell. I think you would have gotten something else if you did that with Shion on screen. I'm not sure. We're gonna go ahead and give it a try. We don't get a game over for it, but this is for later on. Come forth. But yeah, this is something we'll fight later on. Now?
Systems.
since you're not ready yet. Yeah, I kind of knew that. Okay, file number 2. Yay! More detail on her. And that's everything on her. Wherever that is. I think that's where we're at. Unknown. 13th key. First is Shion and Cosmos. Broca Canon. A surveillance program said to be installed within Canon. It's unsure what kind of program it is. Kane himself don't even know. Oh, God. Robot. Robot we didn't do in part... I think it was in part 2. Don't know anything about. The monkeys. The dark robot. Okay. Skill line. Choose the learning skills. Learn automatically at leveling up or learn by using EP. Huh. Uh-huh. Bell types. Oh, this is character types. Shion's a supporter. Jin's an attacker. Cosmos is an attacker / defender. Junior's an attacker. Momo's a healer. Well, yeah. Defender. Supporter. Kind of figured that out already. Alright, we're done with that. And in the next video, we'll actually go on with the game. I'm being serious, we'll actually go on with the game. We will... Okay, just parking by the elevator or by going to the hangar. We're doing the elevator. Freak that shit. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Leave me a like, comment, subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!